In this tip of the day, let's take a look at the very powerful 1CNC hatch feature. So to begin with, what is the hatch feature? Well, the hatch feature is a design tool that's typically used to define the type of material we're working with. For example, iron, aluminum, steel, and things like that. But a lot of times, when I'm working with just wireframe geometry, I'll use the hatch tool to help me further define the shape. All right, let me give you an example. If I want to apply hatch to this geometry, I need to select it first. There's several ways you can do that. You can use any of your selection tools up here, or you can simply hit Control A, Control Alpha on the keyboard to select everything. With the geometry selected, simply take your cursor over to the Command Manager and then select Dimensions. Within there, you're going to want to select Hatch. All right, now as mentioned earlier, hatch is typically used to define the types of material we're working with. If you click down here at the bottom, you can change different materials. For example, marble. That's going to give you a different hatch style. Steel, that'll give you a different hatch style. But if you're going to use hatch just to further define a shape, like I'm doing here, I typically just use iron. Now the hatch distance, that's the distance between all of the different shapes. I'm going to increase that to, let's say, 50 thousandths. Then you have a hatch angle. Hatch angle of 45 degrees is fine. And then you also have a layer name. Let's give it a brand new layer. Let's just call the layer hatch. That looks great, so we'll click OK to that. And there we go. And look, there's a brand new layer now called hatch that we can turn on and off. This becomes really helpful when you're applying toolpath. But for every day just working with CAD, look how nicely the hatch further defines the shape of the part. All right, that's it for this tip of the day. Thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.